Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the next episode of Tech One in which I still don't have a webcam, but I should have a working microphone now. So that should help you actually getting something out of it. And as I have outlined last time, I think it's time to continue with sharing all the pages and parts that are there in the on the site. So this is probably going to be a slightly shorter and kind of more boring episode, but necessary to get the job done. And for people who are actually fans of the site, it should present some excitement, since it means more stuff is available. So let's get to it. My editor, let's launch the site. And usual way, let me get a console, right? Let me kill WordPress. I really should figure this one out. Is this the one? Yep. And what's up next? So Alchemist tools. Let's take a look at them. And as before, let's start with the database migration. Also, let's start on a fresh branch. So where am I? And this is alphabetical. So let's get this guy. Move it along to used creations. Oh, is this a creation or not? It is, right. So let me figure out. So those are the ones. Those are the ones that should be there. And should be deleted because they're shared. So inherit from creation, and we don't need name, we don't need author and source, we don't need rating, we don't need date, we don't need approval status. We don't need the information about voting and prints. Anything else that I've missed? I don't believe so. So you're skipping managed, and as in the previous case, let's not forget, for the purpose of testing, to set the managed properly based on whether we are seeding the database. So this should give us the migration. So make migration, was it? Yep. And how will we call it? Alchemist tools, I would say. Alter field. All right, before I do that, let's also actually correctly fix the misencoded fields, but only if the editor will come back alive. So let's restore. And can I do a replacement only in the highlighted area? Apparently not this way. Let's do it one by one. No. Can I get a replacement, please? Thank you. And text fields, does the encoding? Wasn't sure. And I'm also actually almost sure that description is here now. No, interesting. Okay. So all text is re-encoded. We're editing stuff, we're altering stuff on link. That was not picked up before. Which is actually exactly the misencoding field. Okay, never mind. Okay, so as before, I would like to avoid bounding together, so if I just remove those, will it work? Also, it's trash that's causing the problem. Phew. Okay. What kind of a bug is this? So let me just links encoding. Also of note, okay, this removes the link, so never mind. But control Z should work here, no? Have I run out of? Yeah, crap. But in this case, this should actually help. That's correct. So now now I have stashed my changes, so I can run the migration for links encoding. That gives me the links encoding, and now I should be able to well, pop, not apply because I don't want it anymore, but I do have the what is this? It only removed it and not added it. Crap. Never mind then. Let me return to original state and do this again just because it's fun. So moving Alchemist, removing stash, moving the initial, replacing the managed from somewhere here, for example. And removing all of those guys. Oh, this actually works if I have it. Well, let's see whether it's this time or next time. But replacing char fields. Replacing the text field, which only was here like once. And inheriting. And that was rating date and those guys, which we will discover by making a migration out of it. Yep, only one field move. This looks correct. And now let's do the rename. So Alchemist tools, oh no, it picked it up, excellent. Stuff computers can do. All right, so this should give us the model. 53 is the ticket. Reference 53, and it's a feature. I'm not sure that the Alchemist tools are in our dictionary in docs, so let's take a look. I maintain the Czech English dictionary. So I'm sure everything is correctly translated. Is it Alchemist or Alchemist? Alchemist, right? Oh. Hopefully. All right. Let's add it to the previous commit. All right, so now we need to update the public template. And I have a call that I choose to ignore. For time being. And let me read this. So this is not going to be the creation, it needs a special site. So it's going to be Alchemist tools. Okay. Wait, have I figured out? I guess even best theory went there. Let me take a look. I did, never mind. So let's do it the same way. So it is going to go under common article list. Right, and the slug I need to preserve, I believe, because of how the URLs worked. So let me take a look what it is on the original site. Okay, slug patent. So if I do this, take a look at the localhost, I will not have the creative page, of course, because we need to upgrade the pages fixture. Oh, that was somewhere. Oh, because it was YAML. Never mind. So it's going to be number 15. And now we really can't forget to figure out migration. Is it right? Yes. All right. So old fixtures manage by old fixtures pages. Oh. When I was young, load data. That's what I'm looking for. All right. So stuff exists. We just don't have the folder. Let me take it from here because monsters are also a bitch. This.html. Alchemist tools. Excellent. Unknown column. Is it really the case that we haven't accidentally tracked a number of threads there? Because where do I display it normally? We don't. That's something to think about, that we have like internal counters. Never mind. So the reason why we're seeing this is that we haven't run the migration. So let's do that. We're behind of production, mind you. Let's not forget about it. And this, in a very entertaining way, destroyed everything. That's always a good start. So let's see how this is done normally. Right. Let me. Can I open a file in a split view, because I think it would actually help to just open a file from the original project to see all the possibilities. So in here we are looking Alchemist tools. We are looking at the list. Excellent. And I want to rip open it with our Central European accent. Okay. Interesting how you can look at the old code and immediately see bugs. Like for example, here should be group, not mag energy. But never mind. Pagination, articles apparently work. Name and rating, that works well. Group, I think that that is actually mandatory, so let me keep that. And then A is Mac. I think that I've kept, yeah, we're keeping the old attributes, so let me do that. So, can I get. This could potentially, no. So if we would have imperative templates, this could actually be simplified because I could like, you can see that all of those are displayed in a simple way. So I could just put in a dictionary and iterate through it. But, that would require either a custom code about creations or like a context processor, because I can't imperatively create create those in the template. It would have to go into the controller. That is a bit annoying, and I will just push through in this case because it's few lines, and actually I may want to do some custom treatments to it down the road. I can think of a few. Never mind. So now you will watch an Altman copy-pasting. What's the worst that can happen? So let me kill this. The bottom stays the same. Which also means that it should probably go into a template fragment. And let me create a dump down templates, and we're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Not how you should do it, people. What is the chance to find stuff? Duration. How long does it take to create? Class of how dangerous it is. Power. this one is fun. I've done too much here. Man, the game is weird. So this is like prescribed color, taste, and smell for the creation. And how much mach energy per day it needs. Alright, so unless I made a copy-pasting mistake, this should give a slightly better view, except for, as you can see, something screwed up. What we see, and also the way the description is shown is broken. And should I use render HTML or render HTML insecurely? Let me take a look. That should be template text, right? I think that render HTML insecure is at fault. Because we are here, we are going for the reviewed version, but no. And something actually killed rendering, or no, it's just that the float on the right column is broken. So let me just verify it's us and not something else that I haven't noticed. Easiest way, pull it out. Yep, it's us. And also my best guess is it's the descriptions. Totes. So what are you doing wrong here? Or rather, my guess is that some particular thing is doing it wrong. And also, why is this break here? So we temporarily don't need that guy. Is it done the same or elsewhere? For example, in skill list. Is it that skill list doesn't have description, or I have decided to omit it? Isn't on the original page. I mean, it is only pushing the problem down the line. But when I look at it, I think that even this way, it actually kind of doesn't make sense to show it. Because this is making it all too long. So let me look up which one is breaking it. So I know for the future. I also do wonder whether using good argument for navigation is really the best thing to do, but that's for a different time. So in this case, because we have table like model, we have creation and we have article list, and it ends with main, and we have left and right. Okay, and if we go on the first page, then there is some weird eye and footer, and left and right ended out of main for some reason. Article list is still here. I'm like, what is this? At the bottom, and it even contains pagination. Let's take a look at the source HTML. This is an interpretation. So we do have an article that, by the way, is ending BRs for some weird reasons. This is the real Tejnikov, so this is this guy. I mean, does it contain that HTML even in the original version? Yes. Okay, but nevertheless, this to be further out, there is slash, why is it complaining about this speedo? We have a div, of class value, and I would actually ask why div, and not span. Since this should be floating in that element. Was it some weird flux? Yeah, this looks better. Oh. Well, except for where it breaks out, and this is actually where we may have the problem, so. H2, and why we can't have H2? Also, can I show breaks? Yes, thank you. Let me make it larger so you can also read it. This means it's broken in an inconsistent way, okay. But is it that I can't have this all? This may be why I put in diff, because if there would be block elements in the element, right, that's why. I mean, alternative would be not to not to display those guys in the list, but also what is causing the breakage? Slash diff slash li. I mean, this looks pretty bad to me. Unless because of some misunderstanding, there is slash diff slash p. In here, which is I assume the this slash this p, which is easy to verify. And why is it not pairing? Because just out of curiosity, if we go for a second page and take a look again, I assume it's going to be fine. Still complaints about slash p, but otherwise good. So it may be a problem in the particular articles. Because people use those randomly. This asks for a script to check. My guess is can you have nested paragraphs? I think that you don't. That's causing the issue. Or another block element. Okay. So this should be diff. Which potentially beside the need for future CSS still doesn't fix the HTML's problem. Let me just add the description to it. And this will allow us to have really special snowflake for time being. So description is table like label, table like value. Those are table cells. Seems like I already had that problem. Yep. So this fixes the alignment, which is nice. Doesn't explain where stuff went wrong. And out of curiosity, I think it is the second guy. But if I delete this node, still broken. If I delete this node, still broken. So it's it removes the whole thing when parsing. Ma. And it seems to be specific for the particular item. So it feels kinda bad to be redoing the whole, changing the property because of that single article. Although that would be a practical decision by now. But let's see. Alright, and we don't have it in admin. So let me try to remember my my password that I have changed last time. No. Never mind. Change password. let's try again, also uppercase. Excellent. And the one we're looking for. Hopefully, potentially, is this guy. Is there search? No, that kind of sucks. Okay, that's kind of nice. Also, let me only search for this. Starting to think that something is broken here. Can I enable search? Django admin. Cool. Let's do that. So admin.py. Oh, or was it the model? Oh, okay, so photo. Right, I have to register. Second. Okay, so the class is common article admin and has to inherit from admin.modelAdmin. And I'm going to allow to search in name, actually. And I'm going to register the admin with common article admin. And it should allow me to reload. Unless I broke something. Come on, article admin has no attribute meta. Sounds like I need to add some stuff. Okay, and it seems that current way to do that is without the list signifier. Yep, so it was resolving it as a model, I assume. So now I have search, So I can happily search this guy. Except it doesn't work. Right, and the reason is that I'm in common articles, whereas this is Alchemist tool, so this needs its own admin. And I should also catch up with other okay, so we should also add skill. And now the alchemist tools. And alchemist tools should have alchemist tools as well as alchemist tools admin. All right, so let's go home since I'm drunk. As usual, this is a mistake. It should be alchemist tool. Are we using singular everywhere? Yep. And I've already run the migration, so migrations is another rename. Alchemist tools singular. We'll need to rename everything. But I mean, that's fine. Yes, and this also means renaming the template, and right, we want to give model some reasonable name, and I think this was done here, right? No, different class, and but same display. So no, not yes. I just should be using different console. So this will be unavailable, but now you're good. I can actually see it fine. And we see the HTML. And let me look up some validator. It's complete, so is missing, sure. So this looks like fixing data. Uncause element A is what's causing it. So this is what I may want to be looking for. If I close this, it will not break the whole site, right? Especially if I properly fixed the model name, or have I been declaring it in pages? It was in pages. So, and this also means load data. No can do. So one more thing. I received an invalid article, and I have a feeling So here you see the data problem, and you see how people like intentionally put dash where it doesn't make sense, even when the article technically required it. So you can see that now it's fixed. So it was the slash I. Let's just write this down for production. So this needs its own label. Like that will preferably not kill my issue. Data quality. Something lovely. The pink wasn't bad. All right, I just wonder how it's possible that it doesn't break down the original page. But my guess is that This is stable. So even if the flow is broken, it's constrained to that stable element. It's harder to break table, destroy table. All right. So let's keep this and move on to detail. Figure this out later. Data quality issues. So let me just write down that we also want admin for skills and links. Do it right after, although 10 p.m. so I feel like I'll be ending soon. But let's finish this guy. So we have list and we want detail. And detail is copy pasta in this case. So let me just steal monster detail to alchemist tool detail, put it in, except we will want those different attributes, both including the list. And for some reason, instead of a, I'm using article. Why have I done that? So that's also a potential for refactor. So a dot should go well to be on the safe side. White space a dot should go white space article dots. And voila. Minus CSS. Wait, not what I wanted. This is what I wanted. Check it on the actual site. Way more compact here. I assume I should move it to table like afterwards. But it renders correctly. Why is it doing this? Wait. This is a table. Why am I putting in an actual table? I'm weird. So let's just look into common CSS. This will need a lot of let's art school, designer's love. So page article detail. Better, although this is actual table. This is the article content. Like their footer difference. But it needs more thought and potential actual design. Is what I'm going to say. But nevertheless, this is shared across all other areas. So let me commit this as another contribution and move on. Except I am not rendering the rating. For some reason, let me take a look how it works on common article. Why have I decided not to do that? I am doing this on production, right? Although I'm no longer sure whether I'm doing that on production when locked in, but it should be here. So, where do I do that correctly? Properly do that. And it probably should be another commit. Does it need to unblock? Not here. Since it's a fragment, but it needs to load the tech. Yep. But maybe never mind that, and let's do it as a separate commit for all creations that I'm missing. So let's commit this and push it. Let me also write it. All right. Because the important thing that I want to do is run migration on production. That's kind of missing. So let's add migrations. Let's add templates. If I would be diligent, I would commit links encoding also separately. But I'm not. So. Feature is Alchemist tools. 53. And push it. And while this runs, let me actually create new branch out of it. Random fixes is going to be basically. And so add the ratings. Was it in the list? It is indeed. Nice. It is not in the name. And low creations to do that. So now you can exactly see the problems with copy pasting. You make a mistake and then you copy paste with all problems everywhere. Gallery doesn't have ratings yet, I believe. This is what I wanted to solve. So this, and also of note, would be useful to have tests to see whether I'm not fucking it up with the copy pasting. So this is doing it properly. Here I need to add the load. Okay. Why is there the flash of installed content? And it isn't there always, of course. Otherwise it would be too easy. Okay, never mind. So display ratings in the article details. That's one, and the second one was to make sure we have everything registered in admins. So what's missing? Link is missing. What else? I've been adding. Let's take a look into used. Integrations is what I meant. Models creations. Link alchemist tool, is there skill? Is there photo reader? Not yet, because that involves media. Monster is here. And we're done for time being. Okay, it wasn't that bad. Admin for links. And let's see whether everything happens as expected. Meanwhile, if I'm here and I'm not locked out, and I think I am, so let me log in and see whether, yeah, the thing that's missing for links to be fully accepted is to have a reasonable string representation, and in this case I think it's name and address. Which broke the system, I guess. But only a bit. And here we have a lot of requests that were not approved. And apparently all of those are old anyway. All right. While at it, sorry, the server should be running, but this I can amend. But while at it, have approval choices? I do. So this is what I should have for links as well. Since I'm not iterating. So, yep, this displays things well, and the approval should be an attribute that I will display later on. This of course also requires a migration, so make migrations, links, approval. Let's take a look what it did. Yep, this looks about right. So it's a chore. Well, it's a feature for admin, fixed for admin. Link and approval, and if I push it, I need to force push it because I've been amending. History has changed. And let's see what pipelines think about us. So the approval is the first one that we should merge. That went through checks, and once deployed, I propose we I run a migrations and load the pages, otherwise it's not going to work. And random fixes turned out to be creation fixes, links and ratings. Let's wait for the checks. But more important is master now. And it seems to be running in parallel, I'm surprised. So, am I still locked into Heroku? Do I still have Heroku open somewhere? No idea, but well, dashboard Heroku.com is where I want to go. And I have a weird feeling that I've been there in Chrome, since this is where my one password is, and that's correct. So no deploy yet. But getting there. Okay, so random fixes also succeeded. So let's merge them in a moment. Let's first wait for that deploy to, for this deploy to run. Which hopefully should be done momentarily. And once done, it definitely runs the browser this faster. Yep, it's done. We have a build. Let me not forget to run those migrations and load tests. Otherwise, I'll be in the world of pain. Alright, this will be it for today afterwards. So we are in production. And this should generate 500. Are not found. So let's do Heroku run Python manage py migrate on application. Chirope. Seems that I'm lucky enough that even on a free dyno, I can run Applications, and you can see that I actually neglected to run it for quite a bit. This should run as should be running as a part of deployment pipeline, I think. But given I run on a kind of a simplified version, it's harder to pull out. And let's not forget to load data. And once done, if I reload, all good, minus the broken slash I, because this is production and this is not where I have fixed it. So that I can do, but that's for another story. Otherwise you can see that all good. Alright, so the only thing remaining is that last creation fixes that also needs rebase. We do have conflicts, I have no idea why. But let's resolve them locally then. Let's pull new changes. Rebase on top of origin master. And push it. The only viable explanation I have is that Heroku actually redid rebase and changed signatures, even though no rebase was needed. Or alternatively, there was a merge commit that's not showing up. But beats me. Oh, I have restricted myself for master. So meanwhile, I have a few minutes, so let me go for a new branch and let's talk tests. Rule of thumb, whenever you're bored waiting, you can always add some tests. And in my case, the ones I'm worried about are the UI tests on complete basics. So just going to the well, I would maybe say to all of those sections and just verifying that the title is here and the template is not blowing up. That may be a good test, and I would do it a chain test. Because test pages rendered, because it's not going to do much else, but I think that's useful, and I'm thinking whether for every of those tests I am going to get a complete database teardown. And I believe I do. So This will be a single test case, which is kind of unfortunate. But those two are the assertions I'm going to generate. And what I want is independent pairs of the pages and URLs. So what I am going to do, since this has a single format, is let's call it pages mapping, and it's always going to be the short name. And title, am I going to test for something else? Not yet, but I hope I'll extend. So this is going to follow the pages YAML. I'm wondering whether there is a good way to reuse that YAML. Because this is actually only for creative pages. One of the reasons why to avoid doing that is that if you if I would fuck up the YAML, then I fuck up the production as well as the tests. But you know, copy pasting is only more work. So maybe let me do fixtures is pages. The model I'm going to use is from DDCZ models import creative page. And in setup, well, actually not in setup, it's part of the test. Set but true. And we're going to test page heading present for now. Test creative page rendered. Let's also rename it accordingly. And well, let's do a sanity check that the YAML isn't not fucked up completely. So creative pages, that's potentially to put into setup actually. And I run out of history. this should be forbidden in this day and age. So self pages is creative page objects all, and just assert well, that I can do as a separate test case. Which will end up additional cycles on our, this is all I should show anyway from the perspective of clean testing. So assert assert creator and length of self pages is greater than, let's say, 5. And now for page in, well, pages, not self pages, because we are not sharing it with any other case, so it would be, it's confusing to make it an instance variable. For every page, let's go to that URL that I will hard code this time because we don't want to change it at will. And it's going to be page slug. And on every of those pages, there should be a text that corresponds to a heading that corresponds to pages dot name, and there should be the server title and the Selenium title. So let's see, do I have a new deploy yet? Well, I probably don't because I don't have a merge yet. So now I can. Excellent. Now let's wait for the deploy. And let me run test meanwhile. Whether, well, no. Let me run the DCD test right to make it shorter. And the penalty for hitting segquit is that you have to override the database. I can live with that. And now we're almost done. Let me see what I do tomorrow. I'm afraid that tomorrow is not going to be a webcast day because the day is full. But I still hope to see you reasonably soon. And it's 12th, so Monday 12th. But also, as I've said, you know, country is getting reasonably into lockdown, so everybody's saying it will not happen. Nobody believes it. So what went wrong? No attribute pages, of course, because when one is renaming, they should rename well. Tomorrow should be the blog post day anyway. Excellent. So for not found, template not coded. We've been there. It is because I made a typo. Because I'm using plural in the URL. You are also supposed to singular. Which in this case, I'm not sure it makes sense. So let's also consider nomenclature. And it also reminds me that one thing that is actually super important for launching is proper URL redirects. Okay, now I'm pissed. This should work. No, I'm just great at typos today. Excellent, this is how I roll. So we have another deploy, so let's just run another migration. Since we have fixed the links approval. And hopefully last time for the tests. And meanwhile, let me check if I have an issue for it. Let's call it redirect. Probably not. Okay, so redirect all production or legacy, depending on how you look at it. Creation URLs to the new ones. And that's actually a blocker, and it's going to be an interesting journey. And query set doesn't the name of God. I'm really terrible at typos today. I mean, I'm almost always, but this is another level. And as you can see, I don't have much time before the deadline. So this worked fine. Minus the error. So let's see what happened there. And we are done with this part. So since this was my today's bonus, creative pages. Oh, because this is the one that is actually named properly in English, right? Yes, so let's do this again, hopefully for the last time. For this is 25 seconds. Was it 5 on circle? That would be awesome. So I have no migrations, I've floated pages, and if this will work, yep. Whoop whoop. This went well. Coolio. So let me commit this and we are done. So sanity test for creative pages. And that's all for today, folks. So pleasure seeing you again. And I hope to see you soon with another creative page section. Cheers!